is a southpaw, leading with his right hand. Good inside leg kick from Belingon. And another one.
More and more he kicks, the more it's going to allow Yusuf to see the timing and take him down, which is definitely an area that Kevin wants to avoid. It's a solid leg kick. Good footwork by Kevin. You tell high-level strikers when they're able to get their combinations off, cut their angles, and that's like we just talked about, off of that kick. He missed the belly-to-belly suplex. This puts Kevin in a very, very good spot.
This is part of a Grand Prix event, an eight-man bantamweight contest. A knockout contest, and Belingon has won it. Referee Yuji Shimada dived in. Sadulayev's not happy about it. He's on his knees with his arms apart saying, what was all that about?
Well, you know, you have to take the referee's word for it. I mean, there was a couple of good shots that got through here. You know, it's difficult to say if he was out. Oh, yeah, he's definitely out. If you look at his eyes.
Yeah, his eyes looked as if they were rolling up into his
Kevin
head, didn't
they? Kevin was starting to work on a Kimura, and then he abandoned it. That second shot that snuck through put him out.
And it can often be times be hard to find someone who's going to put together those combinations in training.
Quick hands, isn't he, Kevin Belingon?
He's lightning fast, and he kicks very hard, and he punches hard, too. Deceptively hard for his size.
Side leg kick from Belingon there, so fast. A good left hand as well, as Tan Vu just lent in.
Vu's corner said to get him on the ground.
Therefore, you can pretty much assume they are fabulously conditioned. That's one of the big advantages that Kevin Belingon brings into the cage with him. But he's up against a taller man. Quite clearly, you can see that.
Kevin's also been able to fight some of the tougher competition.
This fight brought to you by Vostok Europe, brought to you by the Red Army Watches.
Kevin's fought arguably the tougher guys in Eminari, Sochul Kim, Sadulayev. Nice body kick.
Wushu style means he has a nice side-on stance.
You know, the best defense is just a good offense. And Belingon has a fantastic offense.
Lightning follow-up there. Belingon was in his face. There wasn't much he could do about it.
Nice takedown again by Belingon. Tan Vu really hasn't been able to get anything going offensively.
It's down to Belingon's intensity, isn't it? He's just constantly on it.
Yeah, he's tenacious.
Good. 30 seconds left in this first round.
Kevin's trapped his right arm. Got a nice couple of right hands through.
10 seconds left.
Who's loading up that kick.
And I get the impression that Tan Vu will get a bit of a talking to from his
doing what
more
you're
of
doing.
The same, yeah?
Yeah, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, brother. Kevin's doing a really good job of setting up the punches, the pace, getting the takedowns where he wants them. And he mixes up his levels well, too.
Lightning speed of those kicks from Belingon.
Oh, nice kick to the head. Nice setup. I think he rocked
again.
Him.
I think Vu's in trouble, although he is fighting back. And he's caught with a left and a right and another left. He's fighting back, but he's really hurt now.
He's not.
And the referee jumps between them, and it's over.
You see here that Kevin Belingon threw a couple of nice punches, and he connected with one right there in that left hand that just rocked his world. The referee all over the top of that here, but that left shocked him. Yeah, that's a close call because, you know, he put him on his butt.
Will it pay dividends in this fight? Knees to the head. Replied with knees to the body. It's vicious, isn't it? The exchanges.
Kevin throws not nice. That's all I have to say. Not nice.
20,000 MMA fans.
Oh, Kevin's on top, throwing some good punches to Ueda.
Get to the head. The action is absolutely furious. And
takedown, not
just
today.
Missed with the foot, with the kick to the head there.
He's able to put Kevin in a dangerous position, and then Kevin, good hip dexterity, gets on top, punishes Ueda with a couple of right hands, and then works in on that. And like you just said, you know, he threw that punch that was over the top. Nice hands, but he is a great jiu-jitsu guy, great wrestler, and very solid hands. Kevin has great kicks, great tenacity. Can he stuff this takedown? He's out of danger.
And I think you might be right, Jason. Ueda may be just edging ahead if he hasn't done so already.
Ooh, nice kick and right hand combo. Stuffs a takedown, big knee. Kevin looked like he's looking for the choke. Is he gonna get the rear naked on Ueda?
Slips out.
Big cut opened up on Ueda from those punches.
And a knee to the head won't make it any better either. Belingon now sees his chance with 2 minutes left in this contest.
Big cut over the eye was reversed. Nice head kick.
70 seconds left.
He is, and he's also riding his last two fights, his win streak, so coming 3-0 in your last three could really go a long way to pushing you towards another title shot.
Good right hand from Kevin Belingon. He's got quick hands, isn't he?
He's really quick, and he moves with such great precision, too. I think he's probably the fastest striker that we have in 1FC.
And there's no slouch himself. He snuck in a very nice little tidy right hand to Belingon. Oh, that was superb. A spinning kick right in the midriff, and that pushed Aranda back several paces.
Kick down to the legs. Cardio. He got tired once. He was four. Decided against it.
That was before they were running the hills in the altitude of... Superb.
Kevin just has that kind of stalking moving forward.
He's got the bit between his teeth as Kevin Belingon. He feels there might be an opening here. Oh, what a left hand. Oh, that was devastation. And I think Aranda was out before he even hit the canvas.
And you see here that left hand that just came right over the top of the ear, right on David's go to sleep button.
Keeping a perfect record against a guy who to an attack is very tough. That's what I was talking about.
And this is what, this is exactly like you said. When they unleash, they let the dogs loose.
See finish. And it was here, well, Belingon was attacking.
Oh, Kevin comes in with everything. And it was just a great exchange.
Low kick to the leg, and then come up top with the hands like he just did. Continue to do that.
Yeah, I like the sound of that. That's certainly what... Whoa! Stunning hands from Belingon, and he followed it up, and the crowd here have gone crazy.
Right to the mount position. Belingon's on top.
Right
He's
hands.
In half guard now.
Left hands coming in. The noise here at the Mall of Asia Arena is deafening.
To come back towards the end, though, after he got his bearings back about him. He's able to try and come up underneath. Got rocked right there with that nice little right hand to the chin. Almost got caught with the technical head kick.
And that kick, just above the knee, which could potentially...
Beautiful!
Oh, wow! Spinning back kick to the midriff that sent Okazaki down. Wow, actually caught him on the arm. It actually caught him on the... Oh, and the exact same thing again. The spinning back kick to the center of the rib cage. Not sure if that hit the arm or the body, but again, it pushed Okazaki back. He must be hurting though, Josh. The legs, the midriff. He's taken punches to the head. He's taken kicks to the head, and he's down again. And his leg just collapsed underneath him. The ground kick to the head is coming in now. Yuji Shimada's looking carefully. To a decision, Rich.
Definitely. This is the kind of fight that shows the fighter who is fighting in a way.
Yeah, he's going to look for Belingon to look posture up, start landing some big punches, elbows possibly, try and pass guard, get to mount. Big time up and comer. So fast, so explosive.
And the crowd are laying with every big piece of contact.
Kevin is basically fighting the way that we have the judging set up. This particular round, I have him in this fight at this point in time, having two near finishes, two near KOs in the fight.
perhaps the best arena we come to all year here. Fantastic facility. Okazaki is taking punishment to the side of the body now. This really puts him in the driving seat for a shot at the champion, currently Bibiano Fernandez. Although he'll be challenged tonight, Belingon looks to finish it in special style.
Fernandez hooking the leg.
You can just see the pressure that he's applying to his left shoulder to keep Belingon's head in that position.
I like how Kevin's going to that inside leg. There's that spinning back kick we talked about a little bit earlier. So he's setting it up by throwing the leg kicks. There's Moon just doing a little bit of showboat and saying, you got nothing on me, boy, let's go. Now you gotta wonder, both these fighters are coming off a loss, but Team Lakai is riding a 15 fight win streak, Peter. Do you think that's gotta be in his head?
And Kevin Belingon still working those inside leg kicks, throwing that jumping in left hook jab, and spinning back kick lands.
Ooh, beautiful.
Here we go, we got that spinning back kick to the stomach of Muin Gofra. The crowd is going wild. They want to see some action here. Here we go. Just every time I say that, a big head kick there from Kevin Belingon. Muin Gofra shooting in for a takedown, getting stopped and outstruck. Left hooks flying in left and right. Phenomenal striker. He's going to start throwing in some knees. Look at Kevin here throwing those head kicks, throwing those hooks left and right, and stuffing that takedown.
Very good work from the Filipino, showing great strength. He's got very strong legs, and now he's gone chasing after the Finnish fighter, who is cut around the forehead, just above the eye. Taru scrambles, tries to go for the takedown, but leaps back up, wipes away from blood, and that's a big problem for him. Belingon is on top of him and throwing lefts and rights. The crowd encouraging him on. Taru goes down. Belingon can't quite get the measure of him because the feet are in the way, but in comes Olivier Koss, and that is a quick stoppage. Kevin Belingon to the top of the cage.
There he is, jumping all over when he sends the slightest bit of weakness in Taru. Kevin Belingon sensed there was something wrong. Taru is trying to cover up, but he just wildly swinging for the fences there as Kevin Belingon puts the hurt on Tony Taru to win this fight by TKO stoppage.
Reese McLaren immediately starts with the taunting. Oh, what a right hand!
Beautiful right hand from Belingon. McLaren in trouble. Here comes Belingon. Could it be the GoDaddy knockout of the night on the way? Belingon driving in the left hand, driving in the right hand, and McLaren reaches up, pulls him down. He's got to control the posture. He's got to stop the ground and pound.
Those are some huge shots thrown by Belingon, but what heart by McLaren to hang in there. Oh, Olivier jumps in. Avoided a lot of shots, but took a lot in the process. Belingon just put it on him till Olivier was forced to jump in and stop. Got to get on that bicycle, create movement. I like how he's switching stances, giving him a bit different looks. Man, that was a hammer of a left kick. The thing is a little bit low.
Back underway in the first round. Chung has recovered and Belingon presses with the jab. Fight from Belingon. Oh, Chino Getty! Turning back kick. Looks for the liver of Chung.
Striking.
This contest brought to you by Celtics. Have a win. Put the fight back in your engine. kicks are on his back.
Come on, man. Keep going, keep going.
He just seems to be in that very dangerous moment. Looks to get on top of the wrestler. Leone wants to put Belingon on his back. This one's gone crazy early. This one's awesome already. Up again from Belingon. Oh, body shot from Belingon. Big hands from Belingon. Leone backs up. Belingon's exploded, a house on fire.
Some hands on Kevin. Slow Kevin down. Leone needs to get on top. He had his moment here, but look, check out the hip. Wizard throw there, but then he started dropping the elbows, and then here comes the knees. Elbow, and then, yep, there's one. That did some damage.
Ticking time bomb. My would friend. Explode at any moment. Oh, turning back kick drops him! Turning back kick drops him! Turning back kick drops him! Here comes Belingon!
Screen, look at this! Boom! Knocks him back about 7 feet.
Manila in a meltdown! That was awesome!
Show that wrestling in the second, third rounds. So expect him to dance with Kevin and see what Kevin has to offer on the feet.
Martin testing the distance, flicks out a jab, outside leg hit, second one of the bout so far from Belingon. Will we see another Filipino world champion? Or will Martin Yuen become the historic three division champion?
Well, Martin's diving down, he's not really changing levels, he's just bending over, trying. Martin continues to chase takedowns like that. Look for Kevin to time a knee.
Look for Martin to time that devastating right hand. The silencer with the outside leg kick for the Philippines.
Look at this. Kevin headhunting, going up top. Look at this. Watch the exchange.
Fakes the hook off the lead hand as Belingon. Fakes the right cross as Martin Yuen. Thought about the right hand. Front kick there from Yuen. More of a punt kick though. Haven't seen Belingon pull the pin yet.
Away with that. Here it is. Look at the shuffle. Boom. Left hand landed by Kevin. Thinking about it, because you know the entire world knows he wants to throw it. Hide it behind the takedown.
intriguing contact. It's edge of the seat stuff here in Mignola. Side kick negates the overhand right, and then we go to the tag. Want to start to see both of these men committing to the wall here.
To mix up these weapons. I'd like to see him, you know, fake the overhand right and then set up that takedown.
Lost in his bantamweight title bid to Bibiano Fernandes. Razor thin decision to the Brazilian. High kick there from Belingon.
There's a lot of tape on Martin. People are constantly studying him. You know, from what?
Martin Ewan. Staying patient, a cerebral
contact. You can't quite reach Martin.
He reached him on that occasion, jumping around him! Jumping around him! How about that?
Take a look at some of the past action here. Kevin Belingon goes airborne right now as he goes headhunting to entertain the crowd. Affect his movement because Bibiano has good boxing.
Oh, there's the turning bucket! Right into the guts of Fernandes.
Fastball spinning back hit thrown by Kevin Belingon. Look at this. Bibiano's like frozen, waiting for it. And look at that beautiful place.
Bibiano hunts early for a single leg. Can he get Belingon down? It's Belingon who ends up in the trap position. Gold left hands there for the champion and a stinging run.
From Bibiano Fernandes. Look at this, he's going for the knee tap takedown. Kevin was able to reverse the position and then land some shots. Look at this, very calculated strikes coming from Belingon.
Autograph signings, photo opportunities. From early in the morning till late in the evening. Nice step across inside thigh kick there from Belingon.
Wobbled Kevin Belingon, put him on his back, but Bibiano got on top and wasn't able to do anything from there. Allowed Kevin to get back into the match. There's that leg kick again. You can strengthen your thighs, kind of deaden those nerves. But that lower part of the leg, that outside calf, you can't train for that. There's another beautiful spinning back kick.
Nice jump turning back kick again. Digging into the midsection. Belly button through the back of Fernandes. There's the counter right hand for the champion, Belingon. And another overhand right from Belingon. Takano giving instructions from the corner. I can hear a familiar voice. Mark Sanjao in the corner. Amazing. Rags to riches story. Wild overhand right again there from the former world's champion. Turning back kick. That one went to the liver of Bibiano. Outside leg kick from Fernandes. Has had a decent record on the road outside of the Philippines. Belingon going 9-3. After three previous matches, both men know each other inside out. It may take something of a surprise. A high kick there from Bibiano. Goes downstairs, clash of shins.
And look at that, catches the body kick. Gets nice and tight, presses him up against the cage. And start attacking those legs. Kevin's got to split the legs and create a little bit better defense. But otherwise, Bibiano's going to take those legs, suck them in. It's very important that he enables, he doesn't allow them to catch.